This is Josh with Eagle Eye Power Solutions. This video describes how to set up for a discharge test using an LB series constant current load bank. The video includes setup for cell monitoring, an option available for constant current smart or constant current programmable models. The first step is to plug the unit in and turn it on. Notice there are two power switches. One is used for 110 volts AC. The other is used for 220 volts. Next, you can plug in the load cables to the load bank. Insert the black cable and twist to tighten it on. Then do the same with the red cable. Now, you can attach the load cable clamps to the battery system. Attach the black clamp to the most negative terminal on the system. Then attach the red clamp to the most positive terminal. Next, it is time to connect the cell voltage cables for individual cell monitoring. This is done using the included multi-lead cables, like the one shown here. Each cable has clamps to connect to up to 24 individual cells. For this video, I will be connecting to a 125 volt, 60 cell system, so I'll need three cables in order to connect to all cells. Start by attaching the first 8 clamps to the first group of cells in the system. Each clamp will attach to the positive post on each cell. The clamps are numbered, so make sure to match each clamp to its corresponding cell number. To make it easier to keep track of the clamps, they're separated by color into three groups. The first group are yellow, the second are red, and the final are black. Once you reach the 24th cell on the system, there will be one clamp left on the cable, which gets attached to the negative post of the 24th cell. After you've attached your clamps to the first 24 cells, you can continue to attach to the rest of the cells in the system in the same manner. Make sure you are attaching to both the positive and negative posts of every 24th cell in the system, as well as on the last cell of the system. Now, you can connect the cell voltage cables to the load bank. Make sure to match the cables to their corresponding ports so that your data is stored in the correct order. At this point, all connections are ready and you can start a discharge test. Press 1 to open the discharge menu. Here, you can scroll through and adjust any parameters or limits you want to set for the test. Once you are ready, press enter for a final prompt screen. Press the run button and the discharge will start according to the parameters you set. For more tutorial videos, visit our website at eepowersolutions.com.